We heard from COVID-19 Response Minister Chris Hipkins just before 7 o'clock with the latest information on the new community case in Auckland. Now joining us via Skype from the Wairarapa with some crucial and related reminders for the public as well as suggestions and questions for the authorities is Lesley Gray, Senior Lecturer from the University of Otago's Department of Primary Healthcare and General Practice. Thank you so much for your time this morning. Thank you for joining us. Morena.
Morena, Jenny May.
Now, before I get to my first question, I just want to preface this interview with the fact that you have been part of two research papers from Otago University, one around mask wearing and then another one around the equity of operation of COVID-19 self-isolation. So you've been fully engaged from a research point of view about how we've responded to the pandemic. Should we be, or how concerned should we be with this latest case?
So we don't want everybody to have fear struck into them. This is one case. We are very fortunate to live in Aotearoa, New Zealand. But we have to put it into perspective. We have become complacent. So if this is the reminder that we need, that we really should be taking those important steps, then this is a good opportunity for us all to reset.
So in terms of those important steps, what are they? What are the things that we should be doing?
So socially distancing, physical distancing, when we're outside our own household bubble and mingling with people that we perhaps don't know. We have no idea where they've come from, what their status is in terms of COVID. We should be wearing masks for ourselves and for other people. The more people that wear masks outside and on public transport, that helps reduce risk. Hand hygiene is very important. That's both washing hands and sanitising regularly. And if you feel unwell, stay home, organise to get a test.
You talked about mask wearing on public transport, etc. Do you think that the government, the Ministry of Health, need to push this message a little bit more? I know that you did some research around mask wearing. This is going back into the first lockdown when we were in level 4. Because I'm not sure we haven't created a culture of wearing masks, right? So do you think that needs to be pushed more?
So we don't have a culture of mask wearing.
No.
We're not a country that would regularly wear a mask if we had a cold, for example, whereas some other countries would routinely wear a mask for the benefit of others. And we've got to learn that we're wearing a mask not so much to protect ourselves, although we are, it's to stop transmission if we have any bugs to other people. We've done more research, so I was leading a 6-month project. So that paper you're referring to was around the initial lockdown.
March, April, yeah.
Yeah. We actually also interviewed people between August, September and October. And those people told us exactly what we'd found in the first set of research, which was people are not sure if they should be wearing them, want to wear a mask. But if masks were mandatory, they would wear them more. People feel embarrassed wearing them, and also people feel that they're uncomfortable. But if they were told, you've got to wear a mask to go to these places, some people would avoid going out, and other people would reluctantly wear the mask.
Yeah, well, this is what Professor Michael Baker and a number of others have been pushing for as well. Lesley Gray, we really do appreciate your time this morning. Tēnā koe, Lesley Gray, Senior Lecturer at Otago University.